because she dreams, sometimes when she speaks, entire worlds unintentionally expressing in one simple sound why anyone, anywhere, ever.
Okay. I don't know how someone speaking could convey that much, but sounds like the memory of your mother is haunting you at this point. Going here. Am I going the right way? I'm gonna turn and go up there. Okay, there's a nice little cottage. Looks like the graveyard is done. Oh, I love these flowers. Hello? Ooh. Who broke down your door? Ooh. Who's mess with your basket? Oh. Well, doesn't seem to be much to this home. It's a fixer-upper. A lot of work to be done on this one. Get it at the low, low price. Oh god, motion blur or something. Is there motion blur? Motion blur. That's really low. I'm not sure if that is motion blur or just janky turning, kind of panning in this tile. Where's the interactive
stuff? For 10 long winters,
stuff.
I've pondered her questions. Is life just a long goodbye?
10.
A brief, bright spark of imperfection disturbing the twin expanses of otherwise perfect, infinite nothing?
Okay, so she's 18.
Maybe. That's why the shamans deemed her a walker and not a weaver. She had no answers, only questions. Questions that can only be answered by walking on the path. A journey to find some mystery to fill the cracked vessel of her heart. A journey to find the genie.
That sounds like me. I have no answers, only questions. Yeah, I can relate. Oh! We've got a fighter up ahead. A fighter statue. Whoa. I beg your pardon. Please do not extend your force field out that far. Ah! It's the ancient warrior Iskromo. Iskromo. I cannot get to you, Iskromo. I don't want to lose the path. It just looks like there's another path on the other side as it goes around. Oh, Iskromor. Wait. Which way were we going? Are we going? No. We're supposed to be going up, aren't we? No, there's the tree that got me. Okay, never mind. I got turned around. Don't you ever mess with me like that again. Oh, more stuff. What does it mean? What does it all mean? Ooh. See, again, I hear water. It's probably not water, is it? It's wind that sounds like water. I thought I saw something moving, but no, it was the rain. I tried to jump and it didn't work. There we go. I was in the middle of a speed down animation. Oh. Yeah, I never noticed in the first jungle path you could actually look down and see your feet. Now you can't. And there's no shadow either. We've lost our feet and our shadow. You see, when you're 18 years old, you're not old enough to have feet in the shadow yet. So just look over here really quickly. And nothing really, okay. You're really confusing me, it sounds like surf. Waves rolling in and out, but there's nothing.
But what is the genie? How could it make a difference in the freedom to choose our own paths in life? What power did it hold? And who made it?
I could only
hope that these questions and more would be answered when I found the genie. I daydreamed about what it would look like. I do not know how far I have yet to travel, or if ever I will find it. I worry that I have chosen the wrong path, but there is no turning back now.
You got me. I'm not walking all the way back over there to take the other path. At this point, that would take me... It would take me like a half hour. And I wouldn't put you guys through that anyway, so... So I wonder if we take the other path and we keep seeing the blue things all over. In various locations of which that seem like they might have significance, but yet there's nothing there. Well, I heard there was some interactive elements. Are they saving that for last? Like, you can pull levers and stuff.
As a young girl, my best friend was Rofesso, cobbler's son.
Rofesso?
He had no interest whatsoever in shoes or the making of them. We would meet in the blue fields, throw off our shoes, and run. We ran until dusk and returned home only for supper, with feet filthy, our shoes lost. As we grew, our friendship also grew into affection and ultimately... a deep, abiding love.
Mm.
The kind of love that knows you are only half of a whole.
Well, that is very romantic. Was he someone else who didn't want his path? He didn't want to be the shoemaker. I don't blame him. I like this. Much better than the spooky music. Oh, look at this. Is this where the genie is?
Let's jump across the gap.
Oh, okay. Platforming. Unexpected platforming. Okay. Platforming successful.
As we grew, Rofesso would often take to sitting and staring into the faraway distance. There was a longing in his eyes, and I could feel sadness in him. I would take his hand and sit for hours in silence.
Oh.
On one such occasion, as we watched the sun setting, the late summer breeze in our hair, he looked at me and kissed me on the forehead. He said, "I have to go." My heart collapsed in my chest.
Do you say it like that? I have to go. Because that would be lame of him to say it in that kind of tone. So why did he go? I guess she wasn't his path either. He didn't want to be a shoemaker or be with Lula. He's lame. You can find better than him. Maybe you could get together with the genie when all this is done. Genies live forever. You won't have to worry about him dying on you or anything. Who did make the genie? Did people make genies? Or are they just... You know... Like, who made people? Maybe whoever made people is the people who made genies. Or it's one who made genies. Maybe the genie made us. You don't know. We just don't know, mister.
Unable to stifle the tears, all I could say was, "I know." As he rose to depart into the great unknown, I asked, "Aren't you afraid of being alone?" "Yes," he said. "My fear is great that I may never see you again, but the fear of living an empty and meaningless life is far greater." "Forgive me, Lula."
That's cold.
He turned and began to walk away from me. I said, "I will watch you until I can't see you anymore." And I did.
Well, he just said his life with her is meaningless. Or maybe he became a shoemaker and he was that unhappy that he just had to completely leave. That was pretty cold, though. Pretty cold. Can't say I think much of this, Rufesso. Stupid name. Stupid boy. What a shame. Whoop.
All your words and soft gestures do not add up to your silence and your absence, which now blankets me. Such funny sounds you made as we lay on carpets of moss. You put a flower in my hair and marveled at your work. I suffered sweetly your platitudes and knew you would be forever unmoved by me. "Forever," you whispered, your breath brushing my lips. I was there, undone in fistfuls of flowers.
So we go fast now. That's what the left shift is for? Okay. Do we... No, that's still slow as hell.
Alone, I tremble. I wonder if my mother came this way, with her blank brown eyes starved wide, rude pale her meager frame. I remember once she said to me, "In a perfect world, I'd make you princess of something, I suppose, and strictly forbid poems." Sweetly she sighed, but fearful to look upon, thin as cracked lips curling painfully up at the edges. "I am only air swelling her gorgon mouth."
Her gorgon mouth. So I wonder why now we start moving faster. Do we want to avoid something, or is he just trying to speed things up?
Trembles her garden, black with forgotten orchids. I think of stairs where you padded softly, of terminal halls where you paced out the heart, in father's own hut, a wooden vault with dust and black willows scraping the walls, in your dull, empty room, an insurgent sun flickering again, fed on dry fumes. Yet something soon takes flight, and she rises sweetly again to nocturnal indigo marches.
Okay, you're kind of losing me now. I'm glad we have the subtitles, though. The first one, the first chisel path, the voice had an accent and was also saying some pretty confusing sentences, so I really didn't catch everything. Okay.
Trembles the air about you. Nothing but embers, her love violet with twilight. With a turn of the neck and a tilt of the chin, she learns of stars that burn, in chaos begetting entire worlds. We learn there is no such thing as beginning and end. Would you, in your wise, wide eyes, deliver to me, in my outstretched hands, a stone? Crochet me into your sleep, weaving dreams in poetry from this darkly fraying patch.
Really? Okay. Ooh, can we go in there? No, we can't. Really. Not that there's anything in there to see. You know, I keep worrying that now that we can move fast, that there's something chasing me.
Don't let it take all your life to learn you were alive, she said to me one drizzly dawn. How my blood swelled with you. In your world, you must be 1,000 feet tall, stunned by your own grandeur. Angled, mystical, not ungraceful, Colossus. You dismiss me with coolly delivered denouement. You always knew the proper place to end a poem. I feel you wringing them out, leaving the universe crippled in comparison.
You don't say.
If you will, tear the sky and be satisfied. I never said you were beautiful, but my hands may know the texture of closed eyelids, jawline, and perhaps that cheekbone you furrowed with creaks, afraid of only age, of yawning, paralytic time, and the absolute center you could forever unfind and otherwise trusted mirrors. I cannot reach this thing inside. Instead, hope falls through your trembling fingers, confounding even the sky.
Which way? We go this way or over there? The red stuff is over there. This makes me think that you're supposed to go that way, but... Whee! I'm thinking they might both lead to the same place. More of these crystals.
You taught tender, while stuffing softer hearts with bitter. From where I am, sepulchral among howling stones, your autumn leaf hands I would have held, hoping to salvage a wraith-racked spirit.
Yeah,
will you not cry out? Will you not lay claim to these sedimentary spaces? Will you not stand and cry, this, this, and this is mine? This only I can fill. My tears cannot be heard in such silence.
Who is she talking to at this point? Her mother? Or Rufesso? Stupid name.
Burn on fragile phoenix. Burn and be done with it. You wept for your own unfulfilled sovereignty, your mourning wild with twilight. I would have held you, and the floods came, gently rocking the terrors. I could have delivered you, in your ashes, from the salty wastes you consumed with fury. Bend never again to this wound. Still you bend, clutching your sides, travailing in chaos, then slowly turn and look at me and say, nothing.
Oh, wow. It's a volcano or something? So you know the broken bridge.
Still I wander this dark world, bootless on Blackthorn, adrift on an empty sea. I wonder if she walked this way. by what dreams lulled. I see her slender fingers, chewed up nails and all, trying to humbly fit themselves around gigantic teacups. There is something in it that makes me sad. I just wish I could tell you. I wish I could have told you. Maybe together we could have understood.
Oh, we got mystic runes. So it splits up and then meets together this way. And then here we've got mystic runes. I don't know. Whoa. That was a frame rate hit there. Mystic runes are having its power over me. Oh. Oh. Do we like this? Is this something we want? Campfire.
I saw a time when we gathered together in animal skins, hunched over fires in ancient caves, and murmured a millennial conversation. Under the aegis of leaf wine, I gather my furs about me and stare into the flames. A torch song of fire opals, languid as salamanders, a writhing nest of fire snakes, lazy ribbons of flame. A dream within a dream, lovelier than death, more beautiful than night.
Yeah, I was going to say that the first drizzle path ended with them approaching a campfire, you approaching a campfire, and there was several other people there. So I kind of wondered if that would happen here, but no, we continue on. Into the cave of despair. Enter the cave of despair, if you dare. But beware! Is it safe here? Au contraire, mon frère. Cracked earth. Oh, look at that. With more runes. So is this the genie's doing? Does the genie put these runes? What happens when we meet the genie? Is it going to be a boss battle of epic proportions? Is it going to be some quick time event? Or is it just going to end with some dialogue and that's it? It looks like it could be a figure, but... Oh! What do we have here? Mushrooms. Mushrooms. That's a
It seems there was something
torch.
We knew then. Something important, long forgotten.
Zoom out.
What mysteries scrawled on cave walls to speak across the great spans of time? What heavy knowledge we ignored for so long that now it is too late? Or perhaps it is nothing. Every generation thinks themselves the cleverest yet. Perhaps they are just childish doodles from a simpleton folk, unable to render accurately even what they saw with their own eyes.
So we've lost our speed, I noticed. Pressing the shift and nothing happens. Plus we're going slower anyway. Follow the mushroom path. It's intoxicating! Huh. It's almost like an army of mushroom people marching forward through this cave. Well, I feel like I'm kind of higher up than I really am. Woo! That's better. Hold on, there's something going on over here, so let's go this way. got a lot of sparkly, twinkly lights. Who goes there? That's quite imposing. There's a lever. There's a giant mushroom. Does the lever open the other way?
There we go.
There we go? Where do we go? I guess we go back the other way, right? It opens a door on the other side. The other path. I hope. Because I'm going to go back over there. And it better not be for nothing, mister. Oh, you'll regret it. I have no idea who I'm talking to. See that? We interacted with something. After an hour. Well, we did have a little... What do you call it? Maybe it opened that. We did have a little, platforming, too. Well, again, I feel like I'm too high for what we're walking on. I don't like being higher than I should. One time when playing EverQuest, back in the day, I was... Oh, I can hear it, actually. I was higher than I should have been, and then I ended up falling through the world. So I don't like to be higher than I should.
I dreamed I was entombed, and Mother pulled back the heavy stone lid of the sarcophagus. She said, I'll not leave you on some high grid for the vultures to pick at. Child from my womb, a corpse in the tomb, my brittle pristine, I've come to clean the spaces between bare knuckles and gold rings. Fear not the worms, for we are vermivorous, even in long sleep. Fear not in your languid vertebrae. I've come to make scarabs of us.
Well, that's considerate. She's gonna do all that for her daughter. Make scarab out of her. And herself. Not every parent would do something like that, you know? It's giving. It's the act of giving.
Often when it rains,
scarabs.
I think of the fisher. He is a solitary man who lives outside the village, in a tiny hut he made himself, on the shoreline of the sea. He would spend long days casting his line in the waters, his skin brown from the sun. I never saw him wear shoes, and his clothes were nearly the rags of a beggar. His hair and beard were long and unkempt, as if never cut or combed once in his life.
It's interesting. There is no fragment of time that will let you keep listening to my sounds. You cannot just give an opportunity to anyone who follows you secretly. That, at least the first sentence here, is from the first drizzle path. That's what she says. There is no fabric of time that will let you keep listening to my sounds. Okay, well, there's that, and then the path is this way, I guess? I guess. We have the fastness again? No, we're still... Why does he let us go fast and then it stops? Was it just taking too long and he wanted to speed up some of it? Or let you be able to speed up some of it? This is definitely a path, and hopefully it's going where I want to go. So you can get this on Steam. As far as I know, it's PC only. I don't think it's on GOG.com. I don't think any of his games are. He just released them on Steam. But, yeah. They're pretty cheap, especially if you get them on sale. I mean, they start out at like $4 or something like that, and then you can get them on sale for like 75% off, so you're spending like $1.50 or something. I mean, surely you can pay $1.50. It's just if you really want to play this. If not, well, I could see keeping the $1.50, $1.75, whatever, for yourself.
The fisher never took a wife, and he had no children. No one knows from where he came. The villagers thought him eccentric, perhaps mad. He never ate the fish he caught, but traded them with the villagers for the simple goods of survival. I once saw him pick a grasshopper from a swaying reed, hold it gently in his hand, as if marveling at its construction. Then he dabbed it with a bit of wild honey he had gathered, and ate it whole.
No, he is mad. I mean, he's gonna trade away fish and then eat grasshoppers. The guy's mad. I love me some fish. Don't get me wrong. Keep the grasshoppers, I will eat the fish. Any day of the week. I want the speed back. Maybe we'll get it back over here. I've been running for over an hour, so. It was interesting how we turn, it flares up. But only momentarily.
Once the fisher brought a line of beautiful fish to my father to trade for a basket. The fish were worth more than one simple basket, so my father offered him a net that he could use to catch more fish. He refused, saying, "Each fish is unique. They must be caught individually or not at all." So my father offered him a variety of baskets to keep the fish separate. Again he refused, saying, "Once I have gathered them, I must carry them all together or not at all."
Oh, speed up! Sweet. I had a feeling it might be where the red is. So it's my accelerando power. So we were going up the mountain, now it looks like we're going down a mountain. Aren't we supposed to be getting to the top where the genie is? Accelerando. Spirit of the wolf.
I grew curious about the fisher, so one day I decided to go watch him fishing and perhaps speak with him.
Oh.
I sat on a rock not so far behind him.
Got him?
He didn't turn or look at me, but gazed far into the clear blue sky of the summer day and said, "Looks like rain today. Where are your shoes, child?" It did not look like rain. I answered his question with one of my own. "Where are your shoes?" He replied, "I never had a need of them."
Is that an elf ear? We've got an archer type. I don't see a bow. More crystals up ahead. This is quite a long journey here. Loosen the fingers up a little.
And
yes,
the path goes on and on and
on. No kidding, lady.
When one walks deliberately, with purpose and care, they have no need of shoes.
I don't have any
but
feet.
But you, you run all the day long without shoes. Not because you don't need them, but because you like to feel the ground beneath your feet, even if it hurts you sometimes. I thought how this was true, a truth I had not even thought of myself. The villagers think you are a half-mad hermit, I offered. He laughed and cast his line again.
Oh, he's talking about the fisherman again. Yeah. He is at least half mad. Really, I think more like 75%, 75 to 90% mad, at least. Oh, an apple. Not that I could pick it up, but hey, apples are always appreciated. Ah, drink. Drink inside. Drink. Oh. What? Okay, that's an exploding lollipop. Why is there an exploding lollipop? Am I supposed to get in here? I'm pressing E. I have no idea. I'm gonna look at it from this side. Why is that there? Why is there a lollipop like with sparks around it?